So multiplicative decomposition is the process of breaking a bigger or complex mathematical object into a product of simpler or smaller mathematical objects. This process, when we apply it to whole numbers or polynomials or integers, is called factoring. 12 can be written as factors 2 times 2 times 3. We can write 14,568 as a product of these numbers. We can write the polynomial 6x squared plus x minus 1 as a product of these two polynomials. You can check that if you multiply term by term using distributive property, multiplication over addition or subtraction, you will verify that that product is, in fact, 6x squared plus x minus 1. So this is called the multiplicative decomposition or factoring of numbers or polynomials. The question is, how do we start actually factoring? We'll start with numbers first and then move on to polynomials. A bigger question is, why would anybody want to factor or look at these smaller components that make up the bigger numbers or the higher degree polynomial? This breaking apart and looking at smaller pieces that the whole is made up of is not unique just to mathematics. We know that in mathematics we're doing this so we can actually add rational numbers or subtract rational numbers or rational expressions. That was our motivation to come up with factoring. But this concept of breaking something into its smaller components and looking at those to understand the bigger object is looked at many other subjects as well, like physics and chemistry. People may want to look at atoms made up of electrons, protons, quarks. Biologists may want to look at an organism on its cellular level or skeletal system so they can understand the whole organism. And there are many other subjects where this phenomenon is very useful. So let's start with numbers. Let's start with 48. 2 times 24, right? 2 times 12 is 24. 12 is 2 times 6, and 6 is 2 times 3. So 48 is 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 twos, 2 to the 4th, times 3. That's what 48 factors into. Many of you have probably seen this kind of diagram called the tree diagram of factoring. So a starting point, which was 2 goes into 48, giving us 2 times 24, was very, very important. The question is, how do we even begin to see that 2 divides 48 or any other number for that matter? So that's part of divisibility tests. So certain divisibility tests, like for 2, 3, and 5, will help us at least start the factoring process. So let's just quickly review some of the divisibility tests that you've seen before. A whole number is divisible by 2 if and only if its last digit is divisible by 2. In other words, it's an even number. I'm sure you've heard of even and odd numbers. Even numbers are numbers that are divisible by 2, and odd numbers are not divisible by 2. So let's start with 736. The test is saying, since 2 divides the last digit 6, 2 divides the entire number 736. Why does that test work? We'll justify just one of these tests for you so you can see. We can write 736 in the expanded notation in this form. 7 times 100, 100 is 10 times 10, and then 3 tens and 6 singletons. You can see that every digit in the tens place and higher places have a 2 as one of its factors, because 10 is 5 times 2. So all of these digits are divisible by 2 because they have a 10 or a higher power of 10 involved in it. So the entire number is divisible by 2 only if the last digit is divisible by 2. So 4 is 2 squared, and we know that 4 goes into 100. So starting with the hundredths place and higher place, 4 is a factor of each one of those. And therefore, if you looked at the last two digits and 4 divides those last two digits, then 4 divides the entire number. So for example, 756, 4 divides 56. And so that means 756 is divisible by 4. Let's look at 3. The test for 3 is 3 divides the sum of all the digits, then the whole number is divisible by 3. So 756, the 7 plus 5 plus 6 add up to 18. 3 divides 18, so 3 divides 756. Test for 9 is the same. Add up all the digits. If the sum is divisible by 9, the whole number is divisible by 9. For 5, you already know that if the last digit is 5 or 0, then the entire number is divisible by 5. So it's very much the same reason for why the last digit is sufficient is the same as for divisibility test for 2. 25 is 5 squared. So if you take a number and looked at the last two digits, if 25 goes into 50, then 25 goes into 750. So why don't we give you a few moments. Why don't you take the 180 and see if you can get it factored. Do the factoring tree. Pause the video here, see what you can do. So 880 has a 0 in the last spot, so we know 10 goes into it. 18 times 10, last digit is even, so 2 goes into it. 2 times 9 is 18, and 9 is 3 times 3. 10, we already know, is 2 times 5. So 180 is going to be 2 squared times 3 squared times 5. All right, you do the next one on your own. Do a tree diagram just like that. Pause the video, and then we'll show you the answers. Last digit is 4, so 2 goes into it. So go ahead and see what you got. Check if you got this answer. If not, go back and see how this was done, and then do it again. And then try that on your own as well. Again, 4 is the last digit, so 2 goes into it. So start with 2. 2 times 5 is 10, times 1 is 2, times 2 is 4, so 512. 2 times 512, and then just keep going like that. This is what you'll get. 2 goes into it 10 times, which will be 2 to the 10th.